see that aeroplane up there? Did you know that it's able to fly because of tiny, tiny structures less than the width of a human hair? My name's Victoria, and I'm a researcher at the University of Oxford who specialises in looking at these mysterious structures.
Intrigued? Well, I'm talking about superalloys. To understand what superalloys are, we need to have a quick think about atoms. Pretty much everything in the universe is made up of atoms. This popcorn, this drink, even that cat.
At their centre, atoms have a core, which we call the nucleus, and they have other things called electrons whizzing around the outside. But did you know that they mainly comprise of empty space?
In fact, if an atom was the size of Wembley Stadium, then the nucleus would only be the size of a garden pea sitting at its centre.
Well, what does this have to do with aeroplanes? Well, turbojet engines work by sucking in air, which gets compressed and ignited. The burning gases expand and are pushed out of the back of the engine, driving a turbine and generating thrust. The temperatures involved are incredibly high. In fact, the higher the better. At 1,500 degrees Celsius, most normal metals melt.
And well, you don't want melted metal in your aeroplane. So, where do we find materials with atoms that behave differently? In materials called, you guessed it, superalloys. In superalloys, the atoms are able to retain their arrangement at incredibly high temperatures. The atoms in superalloys come together to create two different forms within one structure. You can think of this like a brick wall. One form is the cement, and the other form is the bricks. These bricks in superalloys are 10 times smaller than a human hair. You might be wondering how I can study something so small. But in the same way that biologists can use a microscope to look at cells, I can use something called an atom probe to look at individual atoms. This here is an atom probe. It's a very special piece of equipment that allows me to see materials and their atoms in 3D. Each dot on the screen represents a single atom in a material. So next time you see an aeroplane flying in the sky, try and remember the tiny atoms powering it along. Bye for now.